In this video, we are going to be doing some lateral movement since we saw that our we were able to, you know, get some hashes, and we were able to obtain the NTLM and also the LM. So we are going to be doing a passive hash basically, and we are going to be able to move laterally since we found that this user was a local admin for another server. So we are going to move lateral to another server and see if we can get more hashes over there as well, and continue to do lateral movement from there. So with that being said, we are going to be using another module with Metasploit, and this module is the SMB PSSEC. So if we do a use exploit, and this one is going to be for the Windows SMB, right? SMB PSSEC. Awesome. Just have to make sure that, you know, the payload is going to be compatible for that machine. Or if that one doesn't work, you can use another one, or you can enumerate the machine where you are going to. Since we've already already done that, and we know that we're going to go to a 64-bit version, this one should work great. So with that being said, what we need to do first is that we need to set the SMB domain. So the SMB domain is going to be pentesting.local, and that's because the IPSec that we're going to be doing the passive hash, it is in the pentesting domain. Then after that, you want to set the SMB user, and it is IPSec. Awesome. After that, you want to set the SMB password, and the SMB password that we're going to be passing is going to be the LM and also the NTLM. So for that, we need to go ahead and copy this one over here, and then you want to put a colon in here, as you can see, and then after that, you want to put the NTLM, copy it, paste it in here. Awesome. Press enter. Then after that, you want to set the our host where he has local admin access is that 55, and then you want to set the local port to something that we're not using, like 4458. That one should work. Yeah, we're not using that port. Okay, and you can go to options, make sure that we got everything, and it looks like we do. So let's go ahead and run it. And this one is going to do a passive hash tag, and we should be able to get a session back. There we go. Awesome. We have a session, and session is number 12. So then from here, what you can do is you can just drop to the shell, and it's a lot easier. Who am I? You can see that we are the anti-authority system over here. So we were able to do a passive hash attack with the user IPSec over here. So that's awesome. And if you go to the basically another shell, you want to do a host name, see where you are in the student server. Remember the other one that we were on is the file share one, and if you do the IP config, you can see over here that we are in the .55. So that's awesome. So what can we do from here? Well, we can just go ahead and exit to go back to the interpreter session. You can go ahead and load Kiwi. Loading Kiwi, and just go ahead and do the help command. And from here, let's go ahead and do the decrypt MSV dump again and see what we can find. That one did not find anything. Let's go ahead and we can do a dump for all of it. That one did not find anything. Kretz SSP. Nothing either. Let's do a LSA dump. There we go. So we did some dumping over here. We can see some users that we've done before, and these ones are all on the student SRV. Let's see, we can do we did the LSA SAM. Let's do the LSA dump secrets. Okay, pen testing domain, pen testing, okay. Nothing really to see here. So, creds all. Let's go ahead and just dump all of it. Which is funny, this one wasn't able to dump all of it, but we were able to dump the LSA and all of that. So we have the Rabba user, which is a local one. Testing is another local one. Guest administrator is another local one. So from here, let's see. Password, this is sync. We don't want to do this is sync. We don't have those. Did I do the retrieve SSB? Let's go ahead and do that. Nothing really to see in here. So it seems like it's not really working for the low Kiwi again. Actually, let's just go ahead and do help command. And let's see, the hash dump only does the same because we are more interested right now. Keys dump. Let's see what else we have. Nothing to see here. Reboot. PS, listen to processes. We don't want to do that. Steal token. Let's see if we can, the one that we did with the token was the, let's go ahead and run this one. Copy it. And from interpreter, we can just do run. Run this guy over here. Did you migrate to a process that matched the target's architecture? Maybe we used the wrong architecture for the payload. So let's go ahead and kill this one. Or not kill, go ahead and exit. So that's going to close that session. Let's go ahead and go to options. Show targets. So we have the PowerShell, we have the native upload. And let's go ahead and show payloads right over here, and we are going to be able to see all the payloads. And let's see if we can, let's go ahead and make this a little bit smaller so we can see everything. Make it one more time. There we go. Okay, so we want to do an interpreter one, and the one that we probably want to do is, believe it's going to be for an interpreter, it's going to be that. Let's see, reverse TCP. Let's go ahead and use that one. So let's go ahead and use or set payload. This one is going to set the payload to that one. Let's change the payload. Let's see if there's more options now that we need to change. Everything looks good. Share, that looks good. So let's go ahead and just set the outboard to like 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's go ahead and run this. Let's go ahead and make this bigger so you guys can see. I made it worse. Make this bigger. There we go. Load Kiwi from here. Help creds all. Let's go ahead and dump it all, see if that works. And there we go. So that it was because we had the wrong payload. So after we changed the payload, now you can see that we were able to dump everything. So we can do copy this, and this is for 192.168.1.55, and let's go ahead and paste that in here. Awesome. So we can distinguish where we're dumping from. We can just go ahead and make it like this. take some space. We can even copy that and paste it over here and just change it to this. This one was from .53. Awesome. So now we have a user called Savitar. Savitar over here. So we got Savitar's NTLM. Awesome. Let's go ahead and see if we can get the one that I want to do is, let's go ahead and do help. And we want to retrieve the creds MSV. And for some reason, this one did not work. Let's go ahead and do this one over here then. Okay. So no password for that one. Let's say dump secrets. See if we got anything else. Oh, the same as the other ones. Let's go do help again. So live SSP, SSP creds. I think we did that one. Live SSP. That one that we did before. Yep, nothing. Secrets. Did we do secrets? But this one was the one that gave me the error. It did not. What else can we do? So we dump everything. Let's go ahead and see if this one still works. Awesome. So this one still works. We see the NTLM, we see the SHA, and all that good stuff. So from here, we want to enumerate this user. We want to know where this user, who is this user? What is it part of? So if you guys remember when we did those domain user enumeration and group enumeration, we used a module that was called the enum group users. So from here, we can just go ahead and go background this one. And this one is 13. And we want to use the module called post windows, post windows gather enum domain. What's the domain? I think it was group users, maybe. Yep. Nope. Post windows gather enum domain. Let's go ahead. If we cannot, we can just search for group users. And I think I had it right. Post windows gather enum. Oh, I put an N instead of an M. Okay, that's why. So let's go ahead and use this one. Use zero. Options. We want to set the session to 13. Set group to domain admins and run it. And as you can see right now, the Savitar user is part of the it's part of the domain admins. So this is good to know. He's part of the domain admins. We can just go ahead and copy that over here, even though this is for hashes, but it is good to know. So from here, what we could do is we are going to go to the we are going to start a reverse shell with the, or not with the, yeah, with the, with AD, not with AD, with the, yeah, with AD, because the AD is the domain controller. So we're going to start a reverse shell with the domain controller with the user, Savitar, because he has access to, he has access to that domain controller. So that's what we're going to be doing next on the next video. So thank you guys for watching.